So now we're going to talk about tests. This will be the first tutorial of three. In this one, I'll show how you can define tests. And then in the second one, I'll show how you can register tests in different ways. And then the third tutorial will be about the athlete profile, how you define these widgets that show the graphical representation of the test results. This here, for example, is a test. It's a combined test. You can also see test results in line charts, bar charts, and tables. We'll take a closer look at that in the athlete profile. Now let's define a test. You do that in the collections, where you have your building blocks for pretty much everything else. Go to the test section. And in here, you're going to see already when you go in the first time, you're going to see tests that come with XPS. These ones here, please open up the folders and browse through it a bit. You have a wide variety of tests here for body measurements, measurements for different movements, strength, speed, endurance. Now you can rename even the ones that come with XPS, you can rename them, throw them away, move them around in folders. A lot of users create their own club folder here and just drag out the test that they use and maybe throw away the rest. Don't be afraid to throw things away here. You can just delete it. Everything you throw away here that came with the system, you can always go to import and bring it back. Before we create a few tests, let me just show you some different ones. We have two interesting ones here from the XPS community. These are both examples of combined tests. For each test, you always see the unit of measurements in the parentheses. Except for the combined ones, they have a star. Yeah, we have the functional movement screen and we have the readiness included here. If you double click on the combined tests, you can see what tests they are made up of. Nice thing here about this movement screen, it shows how someone has connected a PDF as a description of the text. You can also connect websites. You just do that by right-clicking on a test, link to, and then you can link it to a website or attach PDF document. Or you can click on edit down here, and then you can embed YouTube, write your own text. So that's a way of putting descriptions to tests for others. Other examples, if you go here to custom examples, I just wanted to show you that there is no limit to what kind of tests you put in there, anything that you want to measure really and see the development and progress. Skill level testing, this is from basketball here. Evaluations, grades, some example from soccer, GPS data, and again, evaluation, scouting, whatever you want to put in. Let's create a few new tests here to give you an example of how it works. As with everything else, you can create things by right-clicking and say new test, or you can go up here to this little button here. Now we create a new test. You will have the choice of a normal test or a combined test. We'll start with one normal. We want to measure juggling, how long you can juggle a ball. When you input the name, you are asked for what measurement unit do you want for this test. You can either select from the three standard ones, distance, time, or weight, or you can select from a custom unit where people, when it's counting, use this symbol here. Sometimes you can just use the empty one too. If you feel there's a unit that's missing, you can let us know. It's easy for us to add units here. So anyway, this is for time. When you select one of the standard ones, you will be asked to select also a more detailed. So in this case, we're measuring seconds. And here you see that unit here in the parentheses. Let's create another one. We're going to be doing juggling count. So then we use a custom unit. Could go with the empty one. I'm going to go with number sign here. When you use a custom unit, you can also choose, is it going to be a number, any number? And then you would just use this numerical scale. You can also limit it to, for example, true or false. And if you do so, you have to give a value that a false answer gives and a value that a true answer gives. Or you can limit the results to options. I will show that in my next test, okay? So now let's do juggling style. Now I want to limit the results to options, okay? So I'm going to add option here. So now you can be choosing from label. For each label, you have to give it a value. so it can be used in graphs and calculation. So I'm going to put 3 here and say this is a great style. 2 for okay, 1 for poor. You can also have negative numbers in here, any kind of value really. Last thing to mention here, you also have color ranges because you can put a different color to intervals of results in this test. And sometimes you have tables where you can use these colors. Example is in the athlete profile I just showed you. Readiness test has a color value, so if the result is less than 65, it gets a red value. It can be nice to see in different representations. But let's go back here. We have these 3. Let's add the last example, combined test. So I'll do juggling overall here. Combined test. Combined test needs a lowest possible grade and highest possible grade for each of the tests will be mapped to. You remember the radar chart for the readiness? That's a good way of understanding it. So we'll just do 1 here and 3, for example. Then you select the tests. I'm going to select these 3 here. Give a low value of these tests, give a higher grade. I want the high value to give a higher grade. So anyway, with juggling time, what gives a 3? Well, if they juggle for more than 60 seconds. Now, what gives a 2? 60 to 30, or 30 to 60, and anything below 30 will give a 1. Juggling count, I'm going to put here 15. I think you understand how this works. Now here we had the options, so you have to map each option to a grade. So if they have a poor, they'll get a 1, 2, and 3. Then you can select if the total score of this combined test is a sum of subscores, or if you want to map it to a scale of 0 to 100%. You can move test around here in the order. You can choose the order, you can right click and remove. And you also have the color range. That's about it. It's quite easy to define these combined tests. One little tip here about tests that have different options. Sometimes you're doing evaluations things and where you have, let's say you have 5 tests which all have these options. It would take a long time to do this manually. So in that case, I would just copy this one, the first one, paste it, change the name, let's say juggling quality, and you see you have the same options here. That's it for defining tests. Now, I recommend you go to the next tutorial and see how we input the test results from different ways. Thank you for listening.